multi-exclusive dimensional being Kai with another exclusive. This video is going to be about Sun in Cancer, Moon in Sagittarius, baby. So when we're dealing with the Sun in Cancer, that's dealing with our instincts, our intuitions, what we care about, what we care for, our values, our home, our security. Now, being that the Moon just transited from Scorpio, which is passion, desires, that's dealing with the feeling fixated waters. That's dealing with our own underworld past, our own dark and hidden agendas, our manipulations. Feel me? We just moved that because basically dealing with 8th house, you got to basically detach from any desires if you want to get to the 9th house. So if you stuck into what happened to the last moons, then you're not going to be riding this wave. And basically, what is Moon in Sagittarius? That's dealing with adaptable, mutable, fiery instinctions. That's, of course, that's acting without thinking too. So pretty much that's how it play out. So you got to be utilizing and riding these 2-day energy period. So that's dealing with abundance, that's dealing with faith, that's dealing with luck, that's dealing with wisdom, that's dealing with completion, expansion, travel. So once you utilize this in your own unique manners, and basically this is also dealing with Thursday too, the day to learn everything and basically be tracking about what you took place in the previous time and shit. Also, we got Mercury in Cancer. So that's dealing with connections, feelings and emotions and being more psychic the way how we think. And basically, this is also bring up previous circumstances and situations throughout the path. And of course, that's also dealing with Mercury retrograde. Mercury is thinking, intellectual, communication. And we can basically be going back into time, how we think and analyze things, or people, places, and things might just pop back up in our head. Also, we're dealing with Venus and Gemini, so that's dealing with talking and communication, being curious about people, places, and things, and also basically finding and feeling the need to basically be having your fucking Kool-Aid in the mix. So basically, you being curious about everything. Also, we got Mars and Aries, so that's basically putting your head first, headstrong, basically coming up with new ideas, a new rebellious, and a more astonishing goals, and basically being coming up with more fiery emotions and feelings, and basically you're pushing out and chasing pursuits in your own unique manner, and basically you don't need nobody help. You will spit on their hand if they try to hand a hand out to you. Y'all know what I'm talking about when we talk about their Mars and Aries. Also, Jupiter is in Capricorn, so that's dealing with basically luck, growth, and benefits. That's basically gonna benefit you. And that's also Capricorn. That's dealing with new structure and stability in life. So a lot of planets is in Capricorn. So y'all see all the crazy shit that's going on in the world right now. So this basically, once you get into astrology, you don't got to watch the news. And you will know what kind of shit going on behind the scenes. Just spirits trying to get their power back into play. But we got this power too. We all got this power, feel me? But who are you utilizing and pushing that power towards, them or you? Also, we got Saturn and Capricorn. So that's leveling up, and basically, that's basically Capricorn wanting you to push up, push forward, and basically utilize what you want to basically get to in life, and not basically being stuck into one routine and pattern. Feel me? Have structure in your life, and not basically trying to struck and fixate somebody on shit. Also, we got Uranus and Taurus. So basically, you know, this is values, money, resources, and shit. And make sure you get a woman during these times. You need a woman. You need a woman to manifest in life. Because if you ain't got a woman with you, then you ain't got a woman by your side, you won't be manifesting. And that's real shit. Also, we got Neptune and Pisces. So that's dealing with instincts, spiritualities, illusions. And basically, you need to push your best foot forward as possible. Learn how to utilize your imagination, creativity, and belief. And basically utilize this throughout the 7-day period, especially the 7-day rituals and spells, the 7-day craving. So once you utilize this and make sure you act now in these natures, when these transits go into other worlds, you will basically be benefiting the reaps, getting the reaps of the benefits and shit. Also, we got Pluto and Capricorn. So that's desires, underworld. That's dealing with the occult mysticism. That's behind closed doors. So a lot of dark shit going on this planet. It still is, but you know, it's more surface level now, being Edison Capricorn. So, you know, this is a good time to put death and transformation and rebirth and regeneration to new things and new circumstances and situations in your life. Or you're going to basically let Pluto do that shit for you. As you seen what happened earlier when this dumbass, crazy ass, possessed ass lady. I can't even get mad at her. I gotta be going after a source that's controlling and possessing her. I gotta go after that motherfucker and Pluto that motherfucker. I can't even get mad about her. I just sat back and laughed and recorded her, feel me? And that spirit that's in her body basically didn't like that. So, you know, plays out with that. So you gotta basically bring death and transformation to anything that don't serve you no purpose on this planet. Also, we got Chiron and Aries. So this is a self-expression, independence, and basically impulsiveness. So basically, it's a good time to shine and basically get back on your feet and be strong. No matter what traumas and circumstances and situations that played previous on your life or during this fake-ass pandemic, time to man it up and woman it up. Y'all know what I'm talking about, feminine and masculine. And we all got that within us and outside of us, too. Outside is basically masculine. Inside is basically feminine. Our feelings and emotions. Masculine is our man, our bodies, our left brain, and our right brain is esoteric. Feel me? Also, we got ascending. We got North Node in Gemini. So it's basically dealing with intellectual growth and removing anxiety and not being afraid to basically step your shit up. So if you got anxiety, you know what to do. Also, you got ascending in Aquarius. So that's fixated and natural ways of basically coming through circumstances, situations, and meeting new people, places, and things. Also, we got Midhaven and Sagittarius, so that's travel, teach, learn, and expect, and pretty much speculate your group, and basically receive the benefits of the doubt. Now, about to get into these energies. So, Sun conjunct Mercury, so that's basically trusting your gut and utilizing your willpower to shine. Also, we got Sun sextile Uranus, so that's confidence and opinions and new discoveries, new people, places, and things, and new people in circumstances, situations. Sun square Moon, so this is basically dealing with burying pains and traumas that took place in the previous life or previous past or whatever you dealing with throughout this time, because now everything matters now, not what happened in the past. Moon trine Mars, so strong will, intense powers that we basically need to basically push us out. Also, we basically also got, what the fuck is that? Moon sextile Saturn. So that's basically service, being a service to yourself and basically pushing out new constructive ways to basically build and grow. And that's also dealing with Jupiter. Also, we got, Jupiter is expansion and growth. Capricorn is the starting of it. So also we got Mercury sextile Uranus. So that's basically dealing with transit in the mind, thinking before we speak and shit, feel me? Being more cautious in the way of how we utilize our rebellious natures when we conversating with people, places, and things. Also, we got Mercury squared Chiron, so that's creating a new idea and new relief to basically heal any traumas and shit that we're going through. Or whatever circumstance situation that we're gonna do to best utilize and pursue things that we can psych our mind up to put us in a better predicament to circumstances situations now, so we won't be dealing with these past traumas and shit, not biting the fruit. Don't bite that fruit, especially if it's dirty. You don't want that coming to pop back up in your life. Also, we got Mercury squared Chiron. We got Jupiter conjunct Pluto, so that's opportunities to people, places, and things to basically grow and speculate. And also we got Moon opposing Venus, so that's basically dealing with luck, loving, joyfulness, natures, and basically it's a good luck and time to basically learn how to express our own ways of meeting new people and being more open and shit. Get your ass out there on the plane, go travel, go somewhere, go learn something new. Also, we got we got Venus sextile Mars, so that's love, romance, games, fighting, femi, play fight with your girl, play some video games, get out there, do something that you won't normally do, femi, try to new in things in a relationship. So that's balance right there, not putting too much eggs in one basket. Also, Mars sextile Uranus, so that's putting an effort to achieve any universal manifestation that you want to put towards to. It's a good time to do that. And that's two cardinals right there. Also, we got Jupiter sextile Neptune. So that's a higher knowledge and spiritual growth right now, what we need to be utilizing to get our spirits up, not down. We're going to come down sometimes, but for me, you got to have balance. Also, we got Neptune, sextile Pluto. That's using your power to basically push forward what you want to manifest in life. Neptune, your dreams, imagination. Pluto is death, transformation, and rebirth, and new generation, new goals and pursuits. Also, Sun and Neptune. Sun, trine Neptune. So that's outer success. That's also dealing with powerful emotions and a good soul, a good nourishing soul to push forward to what you want to put place into your life and bring down into your manifestations. Also, we got Moon Trine Sats, Moon Trine Chiron. So that's basically dealing with healing. And also, we got Venus Trine Saturn. That's dealing with trust and being more open and basically, you know, being more optimistic and to your girl. Be like, oh, you want to give your girl a massage? This is a good time to do that. Also, we got Mars conjunct Chiron. So that's following and coming together. Feel me? To basically push and initiate, create a person that's a good healer to basically help people and things and shit. It's a good time to basically be helping people that's in need during these times and shit. Feel me? We got everything within. We just gotta learn how to psych our minds up in the universe, and God gonna always put shit in front of us because we got this shit up within us. We came here to use these things as our bitches and not get used as bitches. And y'all know what the fuck I'm talking about. We all got bitches in us, males and females. Feel me? Sometimes the females is working, the males is at home handling circumstance situations. So things, times had changed. Best believe that. Jupiter conjunct Saturn. So this is growth, speed, time, schedule, routine, and pattern day-to-day. So this is a good time to basically be pushing for your faith and your luck and your growth. And it's gonna, your seed going to grow. Because you putting the seed out there, and depending on how much time and effort you put into that shit, it's going to fucking grow. It's going to grow like flowers, feel me? And also, we got Saturn conjunct Pluto. So that's dealing with heavy traumas and shit. And this is basically a need for people, places, and things with this transit to basically be fighting their pursuits and making sure that they pushing out their best opportunity and chance to make sure they initiate and create and manifest in life. All right, we're about to run down these houses real quick. Jupiter in the first house, that's dealing with wealth and benefits of personal, professional group pursuits. You're good at this, so this is a good time to utilize this, whether you're doing a business or whether you're doing it for your own needs and wants. Don't pass up on this opportunity, or the universe and God can take the shit out of your hands, and you will basically be building right back down at the bottom. Jupiter in the second house, this is dealing with good luck fortune versus bad luck fortune. So if you're not basically planting good seeds from the past previous moon, you ain't take care of your debt, or not debt, but when you ain't take care of your circumstance situation with values, it's going to come back and creep up on your ass, feel me? You can always learn from your mistakes, but don't be playing around, since it's time to really get serious to open more opportunities for more money. Jupiter in third house. This is dealing with smart, hard work, creativity, and basically being out there. It's a good time to write what you want to manifest, affirmations and shit, and put luck into it, and basically put your best foot forward. You never know how it's going to play out. Universe and God work in many mysterious ways, so don't be naive and shit. This is a good time to be utilizing your powers and your gift. Also, Jupiter in fourth house is joy, happiness in the home, domestic, and also this is a good connection to get with your spirit, which is the overall, or also the overall, which is the universal and God. So find your house and know where your Jupiter is in your house. Take care of these circumstances, situations. You never know. New information. Jupiter in the fifth house. This is basically being a sense of attention, having luck, and speaking things into existence, and basically attracting anything that you want in life. Jupiter in the sixth house is basically finding a need to basically have mental pursuits and search for meanings and purpose in life for your day-to-day structure. Jupiter in the seventh house is marriage, partnerships, relationships, spirituality. So Jupiter in the sixth, get right with yourself, meditate, make sure you go out throughout your day with a good day. Seventh house is dealing with coming together, practicality, and love and appreciation. Jupiter in the eighth house, sex, desires, hidden traumas, and debt, and resources, and insurance. Make sure you handle that. Ninth, this is dealing with debates, learning everything, and being greedy for all the knowledge and reaping all the benefits, and basically going out there and receiving information and basically coming to debates with people. Also, 10th house is basically dealing with structure, home, stability, status, ideas, and coming up with new ways. Also, 11th, this is dealing with social, coming together, being a humanitarian, also having growth and protection, inspection, insightfulness. And 12th, this is dealing with belief, faith, God, balance, peace, and harmony, and believing in yourself. So utilize this in your own unique way. Find out where your Jupiter is in your house, and basically we're gonna ride these broke waters, and we're gonna start seeing shit manifest in our life. I love y'all. Take care of yourself. You know, know that.